Okay, so tell me about yourself, what you do, and what your job is for Hamilton Families.
First and foremost, I'm a very spirited Black woman who loves life and live life to the fullest. I am a mother, I'm a wife, I'm a friend, advocate for children, a leader. I really believe in role modeling, and housing is definitely my life. I'm a realtor first, and everything to do with housing, I simply love. I love selling houses. I love providing housing opportunities for families. And that's actually how I came to Hamilton over 6 years ago, is that the CEO at the time was looking for a realtor to come in and build a successful database of landlords who are willing to provide housing opportunities to our families, and created my position. And so I came in and built the real estate department from scratch based on his belief that I could do it.
That's
So,
incredible.
and I'm still here 6 years later, loving what I do, and trying to bring up staff so that eventually they could take this on, and role modeling it actually throughout the state and even in other states so that more programs can create a department like this and have the success that we've had.
That's incredible. I didn't even know. I've heard your position referenced as I've gotten to know Hamilton Families, and the concept of that within the organization of or family a homeless outreach organization is like, duh, of course you want someone who's well versed in finding homes to be a part of your team if your entire goal is to get people sustainably housed, like for long term. That's incredible.
That's right.
What's it like kind of building this department from the ground up? Like, what was that?
It was crazy because, first of all, I've worked in the school systems, in nonprofits, in private sector, you name it, I've worked in it. And I come to a nonprofit with my business savvy because I am very business oriented. And on day one, people were looking at me like, where did she come from? She is like on it, boom, boom, boom. She's demanding things. She's this, and that's that's what made me a success in real estate, was actually my go-to it type of attitude. I don't take no for an answer. And so I came into Hamilton not taking no to anything. And boy, did I have to have a learning curve, not only as a realtor, but as a Black woman coming into an organization in a leadership position, saying what's going to happen. So I had to slow my roll for a moment and realize that a lot of the staff that I was working with at that point were social workers who are very holistic, who are very people-oriented, listeners. They're not movers and shakers. They're not trying to beat a number and market and sell something. They're listening, trying to find out the needs, which is exactly what they're supposed to do, and then move from that angle to supporting the participants. And I was like, you guys are moving too slow. I already have hundreds of homes ready, And they were like, slow down, Mayo, slow down. So it was a challenge at the very beginning, just to kind of balance the nonprofit and business and kind of combine those worlds and learn to work together collaboratively. And once I got that groove with the staff that were already existing and was respectful of who they were and their roles, and them trying to be respectful of who I am in my new role, we meshed. Of course, you're always going to have this different way that you work, but the ultimate aim is providing housing for families. And I am so task oriented that that was going to happen no matter what.
Right. Okay. Well, and I just imagine, I mean, your strength as a Black woman, I imagine, was like pivotal to building that foundation for this, what now has become this department. And I just wanted to ask you, how have your experiences as a Black woman supported you and supported Hamilton Families in what it's become years down the road now?
That's a very good question. I believe that, every day I walk out of my house as a Black woman, and I'm not just 12 years old. I'm kind of seasoned Black woman. So I've got a lot of wisdom now. I've been in the workforce, I've been in the community, I've been in this world for quite a while. Not trying to age myself in no form or fashion, but I've had my bumps, my scrapes, the reality of being Black, the challenges of being suppressed in your intelligence, your leadership, do you have what it takes? you know, being challenged to actually be in a leadership role in a new organization to me, all of that I brought to the table. And then I looked at our population. You know, Hamilton is very diverse. We're a very diverse organization, which is a beautiful thing. And our population that we serve, ironically, is predominantly African-American females raising their children, right? Mm-hmm. And sometimes single. And so being able to mirror the population that we serve and understand where they're coming from, the challenges that the families are facing, and know that sometimes when you want them to move quickly through something, and then we have all of this racial strife in the world going on, COVID isolating us, not being able to physically be in their presence and touch and affirm in a cultural way that, hey, you know, I'm a hugger. I'm totally a hugger, but affirm that it's going to be all right. You know, we're going to make it through this. It's challenging. So being able to say, I know where you're coming from. I don't have to be homeless to understand your plight. You know, I actually know what it's like to be a Black woman during these times and out on the street and need help, you know, not sheltered. I may not know that part personally, but I know that I'm here for you. And this is what I can do. This is how I can change how I work to accommodate you during these tough times and still provide housing opportunities. So it's been very interesting. I love that I'm able to help in the capacity that I'm able to help. Housing is easy. Finding housing is easy. Even when we were challenged back in the day, you know, we only had 1,500 and we had to find housing, you know, for individuals in San Francisco and had to, you know, suggest housing opportunities outside the Bay Area. It's challenging, but we could provide that. The real task is trying to keep the families in their housing, you know, stabilize, thrive, you know, as our mission says.
Oh, that's incredible. I mean, I found one of the things that I'm learning now that I'm like growing up, I'm now in my 30s, as a Black man, I'm learning that the thing that, like you said, I may not know the specifics of being someone without a home, but the connectivity between our Black experiences and how that allows me just to give people benefit of the doubt and how powerful that is something that I don't know that I experience in the larger world. Like when I'm talking to other Black people, I find I'm just given the benefit of like, I understand the capacities of your experiences. And so that's such a powerful thing to just have someone see me. And so I can imagine that is equally as powerful, if not more powerful, for the people that you work with, the families that you work with. That's incredible. I was also wondering, like, what's the working, I mean, you spoke about it a bit earlier when you were talking about building the department, but like the diversity of a Hamilton family is like, what's that environment like? Now, you know, when you started it, you know, there are growing pains of starting a new thing, especially with coming from a different world, your business world, into this nonprofit sector. But like, what's it like now? What's the environment for Hamilton families?
As I mentioned, it is a beautiful thing being in a diverse working environment. I think that we have had our bumps and scrapes, you know, as any organization has in this day and time. I've had a lot of challenges in trying to create space for myself as a Black woman that has a voice and to at the same time stand up for others that are struggling to be heard or to be acknowledged or their ideas. And I think it's been a learning curve for not only for myself, but also for Hamilton. You know, I'm one of the first Black females to be in a leadership director role. And I had to set the pace for what that was like and be a role model. You know, everybody experiences challenges, but you actually have to stay in the game and stand and ask to be a part of the bigger picture. And where some people may not have to ask, you got to ask, you know, and I think that's in anything in this world, you know, being a Black realtor, you know, in a population that was predominantly all white and trying to start my own property management business years ago and successfully doing so. People could talk to you on the phone. I can sell anybody over the phone. And I feel like I can sell anybody in person once they get a chance to know me. But they're shocked. Oh, she's a Black woman, you know, didn't realize that, you know, and then do I trust you the same? Well, what's really neat in Hamilton is we have a large population of Black males that have provided housing opportunities for our families.
Wow.
And just to bring them to the table, you know, providing these units and, you know, seeing their success. Oh, my goodness. I want the young children. I'm such an advocate for the children to see that this is your landlord. You know, you can be a landlord someday. What an opportunity. You know, so I feel like although there may be challenges and communication differences at times and trying to make space, you know, you have to stay in the game. Otherwise, your impact is never felt. And how is it going to trickle down to the future children, the children now that are going to be our future leaders? So it's always about role modeling for me.
Well, and that's so important. I mean, I do outreach now in theater spaces and art spaces. And I always tell the story of the moment I knew it was possible because I saw someone who looked like me. Because before that moment, it just seemed crazy. I was like, I hadn't seen too many Black artists in theater from my limited space from where I grew up, you know, in little Pennsylvania. And it wasn't until I saw one that I went, oh, my dream isn't crazy. So the idea of seeing like this boss Black female as a realtor, as like the head of this department, seeing Black landlords, like if any of those young children have this dream of that thing, you don't feel crazy when you believe that that's your path, when you can see other examples of someone who looks like you. So I'm loving that you are out there doing what you're doing, because I just know how that affected my journey, how it kind of set up the foundation for my dreams. And I want to know like more about as you've worked with the participants, how have they affected you? How have they maybe changed your mindset or helped you shape how you work or who you are a little bit more as a Black woman?
Another great question. I believe that we don't work primarily with the participants, but we see the outcome of the participants. And in some of our contracts, we do work with the participants. It's just a smaller number. Most of the time, it's the landlords. Mm-hmm. But because everything that we do is about the participants and in securing housing, we hear them, we listen. And when they are telling us certain things, we have to back up and acknowledge that. You know, I want to live in this type of neighborhood. Well, why? You know, is it because you actually want a sense of community, no matter that that neighborhood isn't as safe or as desirable as another neighborhood with the same rent? Mm-hmm. Let me help to understand that. Okay, community is everything. I'm all about community. I don't live anywhere that I don't know my bank. Where I get my gas, they know me. You know, so community is a big part of who I am, and that keeps me anchored. And so when participants are saying where they want to go, we listen. Mm-hmm. And we try to provide housing in that area. Also provide an alternative, mm-hmm. but and let them try to see what the alternative is. But don't force the issue. Allow them to kind of segue to where they want to go. So they're a big part of what we do. They're a big part of during this COVID shelter in place and during all the murders that were taking place. We had to listen to the participants when they were not wanting to come view a unit. You know, we had to be mindful. They're going through challenges just like us, mm-hmm. and they don't want to get out there. They want a home, yes, but they're scared to get out there and be out on the streets just like we are, you know? And so, and I totally was fearful at a time when so much was happening that I felt I had no control over, mm-hmm. but I had to get out in those streets as an essential worker regardless. And I had to encourage my fellow staff to get out in the streets as essential worker. And by doing that, then you it trickles down to the participants, right? We got you. This is how we're going to set up this viewing so it's safe for you.
Yeah.
You know, can we work around your time and still get you so that we can have you housed during these terrible times instead of on the streets or, you know, in your cars? So they are what drive us to do what we do. And the beauty of Hamilton, the staff at Hamilton, is that most all the staff are so passionate about what we do. It's so funny, you know, we all are sitting up here fighting for the same thing to get families housed, but we're passionate and we have different ways of actually doing our work. And sometimes there's that rift, but we come together at the end and we house, you know, and that's a beautiful thing. That's what keeps me working here at Hamilton, is because the staff actually, for better or for worse, the passion, when you know that people love what they do and it's not just a job, you want to be a part of that, right?
Yeah.
And you want to grow other staff up to have that same thing and then go out into the world and seek other jobs well after they've been in my department and do better and do that same thing in their next job and be the role models for the next generation. So
listening to you, I mean, it, over the past like day and a half, I've gotten to speak to a few people from all over the Hamilton Families organization, and there's some like incredible things that just line up. You all speak about it in different ways from different experiences and different perspectives, but these things just, every time I talk to one of you all, I hear these ideals of a family. And I mean family in the real sense, not in the imaginary sense, where it's not that we have issues, it's how we get through them and thrive on the other side that you all speak about. And it's like, yeah, we're human, we bump, but we're all working towards the same goal, and we all make sure that we remember that. And even speaking to you and Miss Ivory Collins, who are Black women, I'm reminded of, I grew up in a very female-centric household. Like, my dad was great and all, but like my mother, my grandmother, my aunts, they were always like very much the leaders, the anchors of our household. And I'm reminded every time about what I believe Black womanness is. And it is that caretaker, that leader, that strength. And the fact that you just spoke about wanting, not just wanting it to be good for now for your organization, but let's send that out into the world so that we know that when you go to your next job and the job after that, you have this mindset of like, work first. Who are we serving? Why are we serving? I that's just so Black to me. That's so like Black woman to me, and I live for that.
I totally believe in that. When I created the department and brought staff on board, I was very intentional how I hired, you know, that different varying ages, varying ethnicities, very intentional. Because I believe that we're a melting pot, but we all, if we have the same drive and energy and vision to house and to provide these opportunities to families, we can't go wrong. I have been touted for, she is so maternal, or bossy boots, or, you know, this is how, set, you know, raising the bar on how we work, you know, professionalism always and step it up. You know, I'm hardcore. But that is my culture. Women, as a Black woman, we are very strong. We plant ourselves like oak trees, and we stay planted no matter how many storms come by, because we have to survive for our children's sake. I have four children that I'm trying, three Black women and one Black male that I'm trying to set a foundation very strong so that they can make it in this world. Yeah. I'm gonna totally do that at work the same, no matter who you are. You know what, if I'm being real to me, I'm going to lead by example, and I'm going to encourage you to always grow every day, always move higher and know what your purpose is. Otherwise, you get out of bed every morning and what are you going to work for?
Yeah.
I'd go back to just real estate if I didn't have a purpose here, because we all know real estate is my lifeline. Everybody knows that's my lifeline. It's independence. It's all of that. But at the end of the day, I'm doing the same thing. I'm helping someone get into a home. Mm-hmm. Secure themselves, stabilize, and then eventually thrive. I think that's the number one thing I could say about me as a Black woman in this organization, is it's not just to provide opportunities and have folks survive. It's to thrive. We got to do above and beyond that, right?
Oh, absolutely. Well, and I know from my life experiences that the time when I was just surviving, those memories are colored differently than the ones where I'm like, I was thriving. I was set up to live well. And it sounds how Hamilton Families differs from, you know, other similar organizations is that it's not one or the other. It's a whole package of like, let's get you to survival and then let's get you to thriving and living well. And I wanted to add, by way of that, I wanted to ask, like, what are some things that you would want the everyday human, you know, everyday citizen to know about Hamilton Families, what we can do to support and get out there? Like, what would you just tell a person on the street about Hamilton Families?
I'd tell them about our mission, that it's to end homelessness and that to provide housing opportunities for all people, and that we want families to be secure. We want their children to feel safe. You know, it is a right to have housing. And if you want housing, we're going to make that happen for you. We don't just make it happen for the participants that are provided to us to provide housing for. It's staff. It's the staff's friends. So we're constantly teaching about housing, how to access housing, how to stay in your housing, how to talk to owners and landlords so that you build a relationship that they're willing to say, okay, I'm not going to increase your rent because you're a good tenant. How to be a good tenant, you know, how to make it in this world, and don't settle for, okay, I made it here. This is good enough. I plateau at this level. No, go higher. Be an owner of that unit next time. Thrive to be that, and to extend your hand to the next family that you see that's homeless and say, I can help you. I can help you because I connected with Hamilton. Hamilton not only provided me housing, but they taught me how to do that for my neighbor, you know? And I think we're here. It's an open door policy. And what we don't know, we strive to learn. So you're thinking we don't know something about you, we strive to learn. Hamilton is so innovative. The leaders are innovative. Who would have thought bringing a real estate into a housing, you know? Come on. And in a nonprofit, it's that CEO at the time had that vision. And we are constantly looking for ways to do better at what we do. We don't just sit idle. And that's why there's a rift, right? There's a rift. And that's why Mayo speaks so much and stands and comes from a historical background and reminds people of who we're serving. Yeah. All those things you have to bring at the table. We're thought partners. And I think if we weren't thought partners in-house, we would never be able to extend our arms as far. 19 different counties that we're in, you know, serving our families with housing opportunities if we weren't thought partners. So
that's incredible. So last question. This initiative is kind of birthed out of the marriage of Black History Month and wanting to highlight organizations that work to serve the Black community. And I speak about it a lot. When I think about our community, legacy is always the first thing that comes up, because I know that not only in spite of what has been our existence historically, the legacy of Black people, of Blackness, to me, always shines bright as a beacon of power and hope and knowing how to make a way out of no way. And so I'm always curious when I speak to other Black leaders, what do you hope the legacy of Hamilton Families as an organization that serves the Black community, what do you hope that legacy will be in 10 years, 30 years, you know?
Many more folks working for Hamilton that are in higher positions, that are in leadership roles, or that can say they have held positions like that in Hamilton and made a change in the community. You know, I come from a lineage of community leaders. My father was a broker for the first time, you know, moved a Black family on the north side of town and help them with their loan when nobody else would. Little did I know that I would follow in those footsteps doing very similar things as a developer, as building a community in my hometown, you know, as branching out here and providing housing opportunities for families in San Francisco. I think that as a legacy, we always have to do better at what we do. We have to hire, we have to mirror our population. We have to be role models. We have to open more doors for Black folks that doors are still closed. We have to acknowledge that we're here and that they need to come up to a higher level, just like everyone else, and lead. I would like to see that as the legacy. You know, I'd like to see the folks that think they can't make it to a higher level in Hamilton, that we expand enough that they can. You know, that this is a foundation that believes in diversity and serving the population to our best ability, our very best ability.
Oh, thank you. Thank you for sharing your life, your experience, your wisdom with me. I think after this like day of getting to speak to people from your organization, I am left a little bit more. The world is a scary place, and I'm only just 30, so I'm coming into my adultness and leaving the part of me that was still the scared little boy. And as I reckon with those thoughts, I'm just reminded that it's important to be the change I needed then for the next generation of me's. And your strength is really pushing me towards that goal, because there are days when it's just hard, you know?
Yeah. Christopher, you're absolutely right. I want to give us an analogy, gumbo. I love gumbo. I cook gumbo every holiday. Not every holiday, but definitely at Christmas. You know, gumbo, and you know gumbo, mm-hmm. as you make your gumbo, it's fresh gumbo, but it's so much better after it sits, right? It absorbs all those flavors. So I think as a Black woman, I've learned to sit and simmer, mm-hmm. you know, and guess what? To take that big ladle and stir the pot sometimes mm-hmm. in a population that's not used to having a pot stirred. And if you stand a little bit longer, the depth of that gumbo is the best you'll ever get, because it's simmered into the crab, into the sausage, and all that stuff. Well, I think that's the same at Hamilton, you know, pot of gumbo. And sometimes you have to stand and simmer and keep adding to the pot and stirring the pot in order for all the goodness to come out. And I think we're getting to that level. I really believe that we've done some great strides and we can only get better. And I believe our staff are starting to see that as well, yeah. you know, so.
Well, thank you again for spending this time with me.